If you're a fan of the World Junior stuff, stay tuned to this YouTube channel at 2:30, 2:45-ish p.m. PST. Today, we're going to be streaming for Canada versus Slovakia. Come over, hang out with us, let's talk hockey, and let's commentate over the game. But yesterday, we saw ourselves a huge game that actually was a pretty big blowout. And no, I'm not talking about Canada's 16-2 slaughter against Team Germany. No, no. We're talking about another double-digit lead that we saw in the World Juniors thus far. It was Team USA against Team Austria. It was an 11-0 USA victory. Now, full disclosure, I did not watch the majority of this game. If you'd been paying attention to the timeline of all this stuff that went down yesterday, we actually had an NHL trade that was broken, like, right at the smack dab middle of the American game. It was the Ottawa Senators trading away a second-round pick for Derek Stepan. I got the notification for that while I was out, which is why I recorded a video sitting outside on the park of a local high school near my apartment. And the video was being recorded out there because the trade had just broken then, which was about the same time as the USA's game's actual proceeding, which is kind of connecting the dots there, pretty much just saying, yeah, I didn't watch most of it. I watched a lot of the highlights, and I rewatched a lot of the footage afterwards because it is available online in most places. But today we're talking about two players here, and I wanted to focus on these two specifically because they're so interlinked in a way that it's kind of difficult to talk about one without talking about the other, talking about the good in one of them while also talking about the negative in others as well. Today we're talking about Trevor Zegras, and we're also talking about Cole Caulfield. Now I'll say this, these two guys are former NTDP stars who played on that generational team back in 2018-19, where Cole Caulfield was the best goal scorer the program had ever seen, and Trevor Zegras was seen as the elite mastermind, the smartest, most creative player on the NTDP, who was in some aspects even more creative than Jack Hughes. But of course, we know the story. Jack Hughes went first overall, Trevor Zegras went 9th overall to the Anaheim Ducks, and Cole Caulfield, because he was 5'7 at the time, dropped to 15th overall, where the Montreal Canadiens picked him. Well, heading into yesterday's 11-0 stomping of Team Austria, Trevor Zegras only had himself 1 point in the entire tournament that was scored against Team Russia. That was the game we streamed initially a few days ago, but he ended up getting a goal in that game. That was pretty much it. The Americans kind of got shut down by Team Russia. And on the other hand, you also had Cole Caulfield, who had an assist in that Russian game as well. So, heading into tonight's Austria game, Zegras and Caulfield were both tied in points. Zegras had a beautiful snipe, and Caulfield had a very nice assist to Cam York. But it's funny, because this Austria team, oh boy, these guys absolutely just got walked by the majority of the American players and the majority of their shifts. The score was 11-0, and Trevor Zegras had 4 points, 2 goals, 2 assists. Matt Boldy of the Minnesota Wild, playing against fellow prospect Marco Rossi, had a hat trick. But Cole Caulfield had 0 points, and Habs fans were kind of freaking out. They're like, yo, how is it that there's an 11-0 win for Team USA against Austria, and Cole Caulfield comes out here with 0 points? Well, I'll tell you this right here. If things had gone Caulfield's way, meaning that some inches were kind of moved over, some universal things were shifted just a tad, we not only could have seen a lot more Cole Caulfield points, but we could have seen some more production from some of these other NTDP players as well. Trevor Zegras in particular. There were a few plays out there where Cole Caulfield sent some nice passes over to Zegras, who one-timed the puck, but then it went off the bar. There were some very good Cole Caulfield chances. The guy was catalyzing offense. The guy went out there, and from the stats tracked over here by Mitch Brown, who is indeed a hockey scout analyst person that I trust online, Cole Caulfield had a higher expected primary points number than Matt Boldy, who had a hat trick, than Dylan Cousins, who had 6 points yesterday. Trevor Zegras had the highest amongst everybody, and Turcott was there too, but seriously, Cole Caulfield was out here actually doing some very good things. As for Trevor Zegras, though, this guy kind of had the flash and the dazzle, and he showed off why he is named by many people as one of the most creative minds not in the NHL today. He's known mostly for his playmaking. The fact is, he's got eyes on the back of his head. And anytime he's looking at the boards or he picks the puck up on the side, he just knows where everybody else is on the ice. He knows where his teammates are heading. He knows where the puck is going to go, and he knows how the puck is going to enter the net because he's got that weird ability to pick it up on the side, spin around without even looking, and center it for a guy who is right there, tape to tape, who buries in a cross crease. He's done that a lot throughout the past few weeks, and he's been putting that on display at the World Juniors too. And that's not all, though. Even though people mostly think of the playmaking, the eyes on the back of the head kind of thing, every time they think about Trevor Zegras, it's kind of funny because people have never really thought about his shot as something that is as lethal as it has been over the past few days. He's got 3 goals in the tournament right now, and all 3 of them were so beautiful. Oh my goodness. The first goal against Russia, again, we were there watching it live, and if you want to tune in for another opportunity at seeing some live Hockey LEGO Rocks 99 action, then tune into this YouTube channel at 2:30, 2:45-ish PST PM. But Trevor Zegras scored himself a very nice snipe against Team Russia, where he absolutely gripped it, ripped it right over the shoulder of Yaroslav Askarov. But that did not stop here in this game against Austria, because the first goal he scores, he picks up the puck at around the faceoff circle on the right side. He shifts his body weight over to the left, he angles his stick towards the goal, grips it, and rips it once again in a swift motion. My goodness, Trevor Zegras with the pinpoint accurate snipe. But it didn't stop there, because his second goal of the game saw him dashing down the left wing, and with very limited space between him, the puck, and the goal line, he absolutely lifts it over the goalie, who is already down hugging the post, right by his head. It pops off the back bar and out, and it's deemed a good goal. Trevor Zegras scoring some beautiful snipes out there. Don't get me wrong, Dylan Cousins is out here doing some nice dekes on the breakaways, doing some nice pot-in goals after some very good passing plays by Team Canada. But Trevor Zegras is out here showing the world what a beautiful snipe can look like. And it's something that people wouldn't really expect to come from Zegras, because people mostly know Zegras as the playmaking, magician-like kind of player that he's established himself a profile for over the past few years. But hey, the guy's over here with a boatload of points and a boatload of games starting things off. And Cole Caulfield has been in a position where, playing sometimes with Zegras, sometimes away from Zegras, he's still doing good things. It's just he can't pot one to go. He's at an assist, and that is it. And I don't want to make it seem like I'm overreacting because, oh, Cole Caulfield has 2 games played and 1 assist. What is he, a bust? No, I'm not saying that. It's just, you know, you see Team USA go out there and they get an 11-0 win, and you see the score sheet, and the only 2 players in the entire USA squad who had more minutes played than Caulfield were the captain, Cam York on defense, and Henry Thrun on defense. Cole Caulfield is one of 3 forwards in this game, alongside of Landon Slaggard and Bobby Brink, who did not get a single point. Everybody else, except for Henry Thrun, had at least 1 point. Take a look at this. Zegras, 4 points. Boldy, 3. Berard, 3. Turcotte, 3. Farinacci, 2. Brisson, 2. Arthur Kaliev had 2. A lot of people were kind of harping on Arthur Kaliev as well, because they were saying, oh, play Caulfield in that spot. But, like, you know, it's kind of funny. It's just so unfortunate to see that a player who is as good and talented as Caulfield can be isn't getting on the score sheet when his team and when he individually are both playing very, very well. Especially against Team Austria, man. Oh my gosh. So, going into the next few games for Team USA, I'm looking forward to seeing Cole Caulfield finally break the barrier, finally get one to go, finally be the primary catalyst of a goal. That assist he got on the Cam York goal against Russia, sure, he was probably the primary guy there, but let's be honest, Cam York did the work, and the other guys out there did the screening. So, in my heart of hearts, it doesn't feel like Cole Caulfield has been vindicated on the score sheet just yet, even though he is only at 0.5 a game. But on the other hand, though, Trevor Zegras, my man, this guy has absolutely converted those chances into gold here, and now he is one of the top scorers in the entire tournament, still behind some of the Canadian guys, because my gosh, 6 points and 1 game played for Cousins, that is absolute monsterly. So talk to me in the comments, what you think about Caulfield, Trevor Zegras. Again, tune into this YouTube channel at 2:30, 2:45, PM PST for a stream for Slovakia versus Canada. I can't wait to see you all out there. And, you know, I can't wait to see if we can grow the channel as well with that opportunity. So, talk to me in the comments what you think about all this stuff, the World Juniors, the players, etc. I hope you enjoyed this edition of Ash Rolls 99. And Bye.